going on, guys? Jason Maxwell here from jmaxfitness.com. Today I'm going to reveal to you my four exercises to build 3D delts. Now, it's really important because, you know, having wide, broad, round shoulders is a symbol of, you know, sexiness. It's a symbol of attractiveness. It's just scientifically proven that women are more attracted to a guy who has bigger, wider, more round shoulders. And I didn't make the rules, but I can tell you how to build these big, wide, round 3D shoulders. A lot of times people will build their shoulders to be wide by doing overhead presses and lateral raises, but you know, this isn't really going to make your shoulders look rounder. Here's what I mean. From the front, you'll look really great. You'll have these wide-looking shoulders. You'll look good in a picture. But as soon as you turn around, it's almost as if your delts just disappear. So that's why it's so important to not only have broad, wide shoulders, but it's also important to have round 3D delts. And that's why I'm going to be teaching you these four exercises today. Now, first, a little bit of a story. Looking back on myself, you know, before I really started training, I had like the worst body ever. I was skinny fat, but my shoulders were not big and wide at all. In fact, I think my hips were wider than my shoulders. So if you look at me, I'm like almost like a triangle. And to have that look of the big wide shoulders, we want to flip that triangle upside down so it's wide on the top, going small down to your waist. So it was one of the things that I really worked on over the past decade. I've been working on my shoulders, and something really paid off. Back 10 years ago, when I didn't have wide shoulders at all, I didn't feel like a man. I didn't feel like I looked like a man, but now it's the opposite. And if you go back to about 4 months ago, I was in the gym here in Toronto. I live across the street from A Good Life, which is like the most popular gym here in Toronto. So I just train at a Good Life. So it's a public gym. And I was working out and this one guy came up to me. He was wearing a red tank top. And he was like, "Hey man, how'd your shoulders get so big? What'd you do?" So what I did was I actually taught him these four exercises that I'm about to teach you. But that guy, oh my God, that was the greatest feeling ever, having someone come up to me and say to me, "Hey, how did you get your shoulders so big?" Someone asking me for advice, because I was someone who formerly had no shoulders at all. So I was very, very proud of that. Now these four exercises, two of them are to hit the wideness of the delts. So I'm gonna call those the medial delts or the lateral delts or even just the side delts, whatever you want to call them. It's the part of your delts that makes you look wider. So the first two exercises are going to hit those. The next exercise is going to hit total shoulder development. And then the last exercise is going to do the shoulder roundness to really turn those shoulders into cannonballs so that when you turn around, you have that 3D look of your delts and your shoulders don't disappear when you turn around the corner. So the first exercise is the behind the neck press. So you're gonna grab a barbell, probably two shoulder widths, so it's pretty wide, and you're going to put the barbell on your traps, and with that width, you're going to push behind your neck up until the bar is about 2 inches above your head, then you're gonna come back down. As you're pressing out, don't think of pressing up, think of pressing out from your body. And that's really going to hit those side delts better than any other exercise. And the way it builds these delts is you get such a contraction and so much mechanical tension in those side delts that you just force them to grow. The next exercise to hit the side delts, so we're still working on width here, is standing shoulder swings. Essentially, these are just dumbbell lateral raises, but you're going to use heavier dumbbells and you're only going to go up maybe a partial range of motion, maybe a third of the way up. Now, the key here is you want to be using a weight that is so heavy that you can't even possibly go up to a full range of motion, and then you're basically just swinging the dumbbells under control. What this is going to do, especially after you do higher and higher reps, is you're going to get a nice pump in the side delts. So behind the neck presses, build the delts via tension, and then the standing shoulder swings build the delts via that nice big pump in the shoulders. Now our next exercise is six-way shoulders. What you're going to do is you're going to be basically hitting the shoulders six ways. So you start out with your standard lateral raise, and you're going to have your arms away from you, and you're going to be making a T with your body. Then keeping your arms straight, you're going to bring them in front of your body, still keeping them your hands at shoulder height, and then you're going to do a front raise all the way up until your arms are above your body. Once your arms are above your body, you're just going to reverse the process, bringing them down to front of you, keeping no bend in the elbows, so keeping your arms straight, and then making a T, and then bringing your arms down, reversing that lateral raise. That is one rep. So that's a total shoulder developer there. You have tension in the shoulders. You will definitely feel it in the deltoids, and you will get a good pump because of that. Our next exercise is going to give you that 3D delt effect. It's one of my favorite exercises ever created for the shoulders, and I make sure that I always have this in my workout program. It is chest supported reverse flies. What you're going to do is you're going to set up a bench at about 45 degrees to 30 degrees. Then you're going to lay face down, so chest down on the bench. You're going to take dumbbells in each hand, and then you're basically going to do lateral raises, but these lateral raises are going to hit your rear delts instead of your side delts. Yes, you'll hit the side delts a bit, but the key here is getting a lot of tension into the rear delts. You're going to look like you're a bird trying to fly in slow motion, and that's how you're going to do that exercise. So the four exercises I just taught you are some of the best exercises to build broad, round, cannonball shoulders. Use them on their own, or you can use them in a giant set. That's one of my favorite ways to go about it. If you'd like to add 1 inch to your shoulders this month, then I highly recommend you grab my Delts of Doom program. It's only available until this Friday at midnight, and I'm giving it away for free. But after Friday at midnight, I'm not going to give it away anymore, and I'm not going to sell it anymore, which means you'll never be able to get it again. So if you want to grab Delts of Doom before it completely vanishes off this planet, go to www.jmaxfitness.com/MFL. So www.jmaxfitness.com/M as in Mary, F as in Frank, and L as in love. I'm Jason Maxwell here from J Max Fitness, and I'll be talking to you guys next time.